Hello, welcome to episode of Oatmeal Breakfast Play the Video Game. On this episode I play Road Blasters. It's a car driving arcade game from 1987. I liked the graphics and sound. To me it's similar to Rad Racer, except that in Road Blasters the car looks better and I can destroy other cars and get extra gas by getting the green balls. The red balls also give me extra gas. And I like the Nitro Ignite. It's dropped from a plane onto the car. I press the space bar, and with the Nitro Ignite I am off to the races. There are also weapons dropped from a plane onto the car. I had a lot of fun playing Road Blasters. I also crashed a lot. I like that. All that matters is if I run out of gas. There is a main gas tank and a reserve gas tank. And when the main gas tank runs out of gas, you run on the reserve gas tank until you run out of gas. The car stops. And you have to insert coins if you want to keep playing. If I played Road Blasters all the way though, I would want to try to go through it in only one tank of gas. I don't know if I could do it. I do think it would be fun to try. It was fun driving all over the road trying to destroy the orange cars. It seemed to me that to destroy the blue cars it takes more shots. Maybe the one complaint I could say about the game is that the courses seem similar. They may not be. I could be wrong about that. Where all the tracks on Rad Racer may each have a theme. I think the fourth track in Rad Racer was Athens. The second track in Rad Racer was at night. I do think, as I said, that Road Blaster looks as good or better than Rad Racer's graphics. Road Blaster was certainly a fun video game to play. One day I want to play a driving game with a steering wheel and pedals. I have driven a racing game with a wheel and pedals, but that was years ago. And I think it's fun. Playing a racing game with steering wheel and pedals is for me a lot more fun than playing it using a keyboard or a directional pad and buttons. That is all I have to say about Road Blaster. What else do I want to talk about? Let me think. I think it would be fun to learn how to play the recorder. I remember when I was school I played the recorder for probably a year. I think we also had to learn how to play it in music class. I would want to get a cheap plastic recorder and learn how to play it. The one I had to play in music class was wood. I don't remember how long I had the recorder for music class. It might have been a year. Or maybe it was half the year. I also played the trombone and trumpet for music class. I can't remember how long I played those either. I probably played them for a year each. I don't know why I wanted to drop the trombone and play the trumpet. I don't remember practicing the trombone or the trumpet. Back then I never thought of writing my own music for the trombone. I don't remember if I never got to take the trombone home or if I had to leave it in the music room. I don't think a trombone would have fit in a locker. Maybe I wanted to play any instrument that I did not play. The reason why I think it would be fun to get a cheap plastic recorder and a cheap plastic harmonica is because I once read about a music group that uses kids' instruments to play music. I thought, how cool is that? I would rather use cheap plastic instruments than play expensive instruments. What else do I want to talk about? At least I have made it to 475 episodes of the show. Maybe I need to find another YouTube niche that I would do better in. I could do another niche and still do this show. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye bye.